One thing that's totally different with the Foundation library compared to older component libraries is you have the option to use the Library Update Utility tool. Now, this is a different way to update your library compared to the way that we had to do it in the past, which is a way more time-consuming process. Now, Toolbox can use this tool and run that update on all your products and subassemblies to make sure that they're up to the latest version. So fixing any issues or improvements that need to be added. Now, you don't have to update your library. Not everybody does. But if you do want to go down that road, this video will help you out and get a little better understanding of how it all works. So let's get into it. Under the options in Toolbox Setup, over to the Utilities tab, we have this Library Update Utility button. I'm going to say no for now, because before we do that, we want to make sure that we actually have this utility package, as we call it, in our desktop or somewhere that we can browse and find so we can actually update our database. So a few things to mention here. Currently, I'm on an older library. I'm about 2 updates behind, which isn't the end of the world. The way that these update utility packages work is they're cumulative updates. So they'll update us from each version that we're behind. So basically, if I jump to a 09.19 build, which I'm going to do, it's going to automatically go through that previous build, which was an 08 something, and just make sure that it updates it correctly. So let's go through the steps on how we would do that. First, we got to go to microvellum.com into our knowledge base network. So here we are on the Microvellum website. Under menu, go to learn and community. Now this takes us directly to the community forums, which are great to get some additional information from other people out there using the software. But now that we're in here, we can go to our knowledge base. And if you see your screen like this, it just means that you're not signed in. So make sure that you do have an account. The account's free, just requires an email and password to set it up. So let's go ahead and log in. Now that we're signed in, we see that this additional button appeared called Downloads. Select that under Product Libraries. This is where you're going to find the update packages. So this will be for the Foundation Library. That's what we're currently working on. And then this page you're going to want to save. There's some good helpful tips and information on here. One note to keep in mind is that you need to be on a build that's no earlier than 22.0729. Okay. Now, if you are on a build that's old, I would recommend going through the steps to make sure that you get it up to a point where you can use these cumulative updates. And this article will walk you through all those steps. This is the most recent update, the 09.19, the phase one cumulative update. If you are on a build that's the 22.0729 build, you're going to want to run this one first to get you up to this version. And then from there, you can run the phase two. Now, since we're already on a build that's 23, we can just download our phase two cumulative update. So just select that, it'll start downloading in the background. So it's going into our downloads folder if you want. You can move it somewhere else, just making sure that you keep it on your local drive. Now back into Toolbox, I'm going to go back to our Update Utility tool. And now from here, we're going to want to browse to the location of where we had that Update Utility package. So I've moved it over to my desktop. We don't need to unzip it, just hit open. The Advanced mode, recommended for only advanced users. But what that advanced mode does, it allows you to uncheck some of these components. So if you don't want these components to be updated in your library, you have the option to uncheck them here. Something also to keep in mind for like your project wizard or your global variables, the current values that you have set inside of those will not change. So it's not going to override any existing. And here's the list of all the products and subassemblies that are going to be updated. Now it's only looking for the name that matches this update. So any unique product or unique subassembly that you've named differently won't show up in this list and won't be overwritten. Now, after you decide on how to handle all these updates, just hit OK and let Toolbox do its thing. So at this point, everything's been updated. We're just going to close out of here and restart Toolbox. So this is the configuration that's just been updated. Now, if it happens to have a name that matches maybe the old library version, you can always change the name of this configuration. So just by selecting it in here and go through the process, just something unique at the end so we can find it in our common Microvellum data folder. Okay, so same configuration, just a different name. You can see we have our library updated to 09.19. Now, if we go to the Help tab and browse the Microvellum data into our common Microvellum data folder, into our configuration, you can see here this name still isn't matching up. I don't know if you're overly anal like I am, then this would be important to you. Now, once we do this, we may have a problem in Toolbox with it not finding that data source. So if you make that name change, just make sure you close out of Toolbox. Now let's fire it up again and double check to make sure that we're looking to the correct configuration. We're going to select our configuration. Now it says that the path to the microvalent data cannot be found because we changed the name of it. I'm not working on a server or anything, so it's just a local configuration. Here we are, common microvalent data. There's the configuration with the name that I just changed. Just selecting on that configuration, hit OK, continue. Now this is the configuration we've been using through the entire training series. So you'll see as I open up my project list, I have everything still there. Now something to keep in mind, when you are running this update utility, it's not affecting any of your existing projects. It's only updating your template components with new variables or new materials and hardware, of course your products. I would suggest running the update utility after your projects are completed, or just understanding that if you go back into an older project and then draw in new products, you may have some issues because it's looking to files that don't exist in that project. Okay, so now we got our library updated and we're ready to take advantage of all this cool stuff that's just been added. Well, thanks again for watching another video brought to you by your good friends here at Microvalent.